Welcome to the Azure AD Architecture Deep Dive Series. I'm Michael Epping, and I'm a Program Manager on the Identity Division Engineering Team at Microsoft.
And hello, my name is Tariq Dawood, and I'm also a Program Manager in the Identity Division's Engineering Team.
We're part of the Customer Experience Program, and we help enterprises and organizations from all over the world to deploy our services, get to the cloud, and in the process, we learn and help our product improve. We get a lot of questions about how Azure AD works under the hood, which we'll share with you throughout this architecture series. In this video, we're going to cover the core directory store and data centers. So Tariq, my first question is, what even is the core store?
That is a great question, Michael. The core store is not a term or expression that we use a lot when we talk to customers externally, and so many of our customers may not be familiar with it. When we refer to the core store, we think of it's the store that houses all the essential data that Azure Active Directory needs to successfully authenticate and authorize users. And so you can think of it as users, devices, groups, policies. It does not include other things that you, other types of data that you may be creating in Azure Active Directory. So to give you an example, when you use the Azure Active Directory feature Access Reviews, you create a review, which is an object stored somewhere that actually says every 3 months people who have access to this application should be checked or should be reviewed. That record is not stored in the core store that we're going to talk about today. It's stored in some other store that is also, you know, highly available and redundant and resilient and so forth, but it is not deemed necessary for the moment of access or authentication or authorization. It is accessed after the fact to, you know, perform a review of people who have access. And so if you ever wonder about any given service, whether it's stored in the core store or somewhere else, we have guidance for this in a website we're going to share also in our slides, https://aka.ms/aaddatamap.
So back to the core store, how does it relate to data centers and where my data actually lives?
There's a number of concepts related to the core store and how it affects the storage of the customer's data. We're going to talk today about regions, we're going to talk about data centers, and we're going to talk in future videos about scale units and replicas. And so why don't we go to take a look at the diagram to start illustrating this?
Sounds like a plan.
So when customers sign up for Microsoft services, as I mentioned, they often register their address with the product they're buying, whether it's Power BI, Office 365, Azure, and so forth. Based on where the customer declares that they're based, they can either end up, if they provide us an address in the Americas, they will end up in US-based data centers. If they provide an address in Europe, the Middle East, or Africa, what we call EMEA, they will end up in European data centers. If they provide an address east of that, so basically India, East Asia, they will end up in the APAC, Asia Pacific data centers. So this is where their core store data is going to reside. This is users, devices, conditional access policies, things that are essential to authentication. Everything that you know about Azure AD and other features and so forth are basically components and services running on top of this core store. So you have the authentication layer, which takes care of issuing tokens, enforcing policy. You've got on top of that the graph layer, which does directory queries and writes. And then you've got all the familiar features you're aware of: self-service password reset, self-service group management, application proxy. All these are different services. They may be running in different data centers in Azure, but ultimately they access the core store to do essential functions. The website in the top right, aka.ms/aaddatamap, is a very useful site to go visit, where you can actually check to put in your region as a customer and then check the specific Azure Active Directory service to see where they're serving you content from, or where they're basically providing you services from.
So how many copies of a customer's data are found within a region?
So each region will have multiple data centers, as you see in the picture here. And within each data center, there are at least 3 copies of the customer's data. So in some regions, we have a minimum of 2 data centers. In some regions, we have 4, we have 6. And so basically, at the very least, the customer's data is in 6 copies across 2 data centers. In some regions, it's as many as 18 copies in 6 data centers.
How do I know what region my Azure AD core store data is in?
That's a great question, Michael. So a lot of times customers wonder about that. The way you can find out is if you go to the Azure Active Directory portal, and then you click on the properties tab, and then check the location. So you'll see here in this case, the customer picked the above value of the United States as their address. And as a result of that, their location of the services of their core store is United States data centers.
So what if I created my tenant in North America, but my company really operates in EMEA?
We do have cases like this where a customer initially set a country that's incorrectly or the company moved. In this case, customers can open a support ticket to request that they be moved to the region that they would be more compliant in. So for example, a European customer who accidentally created themselves in APAC may request to be moved to the EMEA region. And in this case, support will walk them through the process, in which we will silently copy their data over to the European region and remove it from the APAC region, and then let them know when that's been completed.
So what if I'm a multinational who operates globally? How do I choose the right region when I'm working with support?
That's also a great question, Michael. So we have a special configuration for large multinationals that are truly have employees spread around the world. We have a special configuration called the Worldwide Scale Unit, where we put customers when we put customers in that scale unit, they are basically they have a presence in each region, so they can serve the US users from the US copies, and they can serve the European users from the Europe copies, and they can serve the APAC users from the APAC copies. It is a special configuration. It's not readily available for every customer, but if you make your case to support, then we can look into it.
So to wrap things up, how do the core store and various Azure regions benefit Azure AD customers?
The core store and Azure Active Directory does a number of things to help our customers. On the one hand, as we discussed, it stores all the essential information, data that is necessary to help users succeed in accessing the information they need securely. That means user information, credentials, devices, groups, policies. The second thing it does is it stores the customer data in a regional fashion based on the region that the customer resides in. So it prevents unnecessary replication of customer data to regions where it's not needed. But at the same time, in the same region, it stores the customer data in multiple data centers, multiple copies within each data center, to provide data redundancy so that a major event would not take out our customer ability to access and authenticate.
That makes sense. It sounds like the core store, while not always something we may think of when we talk about Azure AD, is a critical part of the system that Microsoft manages for us, with all the built-in performance, scaling, replication, and data protection that you'd want.
You got it, Mike.
We hope you found this video useful. We'll be adding videos on different topics like authentication, provisioning, governance, and many more. If you want to get a copy of the diagrams we used today, or want to give us feedback and help us figure out what to cover next, please follow the link on the screen.